"No," she answered, laughing.
"Then you know nothing about it," he said. "I haven't inquired who you are, but it doesn't matter. While we're at luncheon, I'll tell you all my troubles. They're a great deal more interesting than anything you can say about yourself."
"Perhaps they are, to you," replied Dorothy.
"Luncheon is served," cried Blinkem, throwing open the door, and in came a dozen rabbits in livery, all bearing trays which they placed upon the table, where they arranged the dishes in an orderly manner.
"Now clear out, all of you," exclaimed the king. "Bristle, you may wait outside in case I want you."
When they had gone and the king was alone with Dorothy, he came down from his throne, tossed his crown into a corner, and kicked his ermine robe under the table.
"Sit down," he said, "and try to be happy. It's useless for me to try, because I'm always wretched and miserable. But I'm hungry, and I hope you are."
"I am," said Dorothy. "I've only eaten a wheelbarrow and a piano today. Oh, yes, and a slice of bread and butter that used to be a doormat."
"That sounds like a square meal," remarked the king, seating himself opposite her. "But perhaps it wasn't a square piano, eh?"
Dorothy laughed.
"You don't seem so unhappy now," she said.
"But I am," protested the king, fresh tears gathering in his eyes. "Even my jokes are miserable. I'm wretched, woeful, afflicted, distressed, and dismal as an individual can be. Oh, you're not sorry for me?"
"No," answered Dorothy honestly. "I can't say I am. Seems to me that for a rabbit you're right in clover. This is the prettiest little city I ever saw."
"Oh, the city is good enough," he admitted. "Glinda the Good Sorceress made it for us because she was fond of rabbits. I don't mind the city so much, although I wouldn't live here if I had my choice. It is being king that has absolutely ruined my happiness."
"Why wouldn't you live here by choice?" she asked.
"Because it is all unnatural, my dear. Rabbits are out of place in such luxury. When I was young, I lived in a burrow in the forest. I was surrounded by enemies and often had to run for my life. It was hard getting enough to eat at times, and when I found a bunch of clover, I had to listen and look for danger while I ate it. Wolves prowled around the hole in which I lived, and sometimes I didn't stir out for days at a time. Oh, how happy and contented I was then! I was a real rabbit, as nature made me, wild and free, and I even enjoyed listening to the startled throbbing of my own heart."